stays the same. And we just add these two together. So 0, negative 17, and negative 34. This looks a little messy. Don't really want to work with that, so we can simplify that by dividing negative 17 and still doesn't change up here. And it becomes 0, 1, 2. So we have our 0 here, our 1 here, and it's nice and simple to work with. So now we move on to getting the top row in the right format. We just do the same thing. So we want to add these two rows to make it work out. So what I do is multiply that bottom row by 2. And you keep multiplying it out. Then you get to add the rows. So this time we're adding them into the top row. So add row 2 to row 1. This row doesn't change, but the top row changes. 5 plus 0 stays as 5. That's a 0, and that's a 10. So now we have all our zeros. We just need to divide out so we get 1s. So a fifth of row 1 and a half of row 2. Multiply that through, and it's 1, 0, 2, and 0, 1, 2. This right here is our answer. So x, which is the first one, so x equals 2, y equals 2. There's your answer. Nice and simple. It's much easier once you get it down in this form instead of plugging in x and y, doing some substitution. Substitution works for something this small, but once you get to bigger matrices or bigger sets of numbers, then you'll start to have problems. Like this. So now I'm going to do number 4 on the worksheet. This time we have a 3x3, so it's a bit more complicated. This is why you want to use a matrix. Because substitution would get very nasty trying to solve that. So we start with our equation. We take out the x so that we can put it in an augmented matrix. And now we just want to solve. Well, we find what's our diagonal. Where do we want the ones? One here, one here, one here. So we turn the rest into zeros. So, first we take, we have a 0 here, so we want to get this to be 0. So we're going to add, we can see that we have negative 3 times this row plus this row, that'll give us 0. So we want to just add that up. So we have negative, hold on, we want negative 3 times this row plus this row. So negative 3R1 plus R3. We're turning that into a matrix. So we don't change the top row because that's still the same as the before. The middle row is also not being changed, just the bottom row. So we take negative 3 times this plus this, so that'll give us 3 minus 3, which is 0. That's what we're trying to go for. And we got to do the same thing to the rest of the row. So 6 plus 4, and we have negative 12 plus 1, and then we have 9 minus 6, has three. So now, we want to narrow down our other columns. One thing about row reducing is that it's always easier to do it by eliminating this part first. Turn all that into zeros before you do the top part. It just makes things simpler. So, we're going to want to make that one a zero. First, I can see that this row is divisible by 2, so I'm just going to divide that by 2 really quick. Because it's a lot easier to work with nice numbers. So, divide by 2. And now we want to keep going, so... As you can see, we can add negative 5 times this row plus this row. That'll give us a 0 right here. So let's do that. Negative 5 times the second row plus the third row. The reason why we don't choose the first row is because if we add these together, this 0 wouldn't stay here. You need to add the two rows that already have zeros in them. Because we're trying to get as many zeros as we can. If they fall out, we're doing it wrong. So we take negative 2 times 5. That's negative 10 plus 10. We'll just do the bottom row first. So that comes out to 0. 5 minus 11. That's negative 6. And... 15 plus 3, it's 18. And then the other rows didn't change, so we can just write them down. And now, we have a bunch of zeros, so we can simplify this pretty quickly. Oops. What was that? So now we wanna, let's just make the numbers simple. So divide this row by negative 6. Again, they don't change. And this row is just the same thing, divided by negative 6, so that's 1, negative 3. Now we know one of the values, so we can use this 1. Since there are two zeros here, we don't have to worry about them changing the column, so we can use this one to clear out the rows.